Tonight, some state employees tell Team 4 they are working in a sick building.
They say state officials are ignoring the problem. The building downtown houses local offices for the Department of Labor and Industry. Here's Team 4's Paul Van Osdol.
Earlier this year, more than 40 state employees working in this downtown office building got sick after the building was disinfected with strong chemicals. The employees say this is only the latest in a series of health concerns they've had since moving into the building several years ago.
The most recent problem started with a bad stench that turned out to be a dead rat inside the walls. After the rat was removed, the building owner used a deodorizer to get rid of the smell. But that
caused workers at the work site to have medical problems, respiratory problems, sinus problems, breathing problems, eye problems.
Between 40 and 50 employees filed worker compensation claims.
Even though dozens of employees got sick here, the state never posted any warnings for the general public who use these offices.
We're also concerned about the clients that come into the building, people with disabilities that we serve. They're not necessarily coming to what we consider a safe environment.
One of those clients is Dennis Kassane, who says people with disabilities, the principal users of the office, are more likely to have breathing problems.
If the substance is in the air and they're breathing it in, it could have long-term consequences.
But a spokesman for the state Labor and Industry Department says the deodorizer was safe. It's the same substance used to clean bathrooms. Also, he says the state has done 2 air quality tests, and based on the results, nothing has been found to indicate there's a health risk to employees in the building.
Earlier this month, the employees here sent these letters to state legislators and candidates for governor asking for their help and to move out of this building. So far, they've gotten no response. Reporting from downtown, Paul Van Osdol, Channel 4 Action News.